What's up, guys? G Martin here. In this video, we're going to be talking about 5 tips you need to know for really any DJI drone, honestly. I'm doing it for the DJI Spark, but it goes for all, so stay tuned. So we're going to start this off at a tip number 1, and that is make sure before you take off you have GPS signal. Because I've been in a few situations where I'll take off and I'll only have the like vision altitude hold where it does not have GPS, and it'll just go insane on me. And it'll start flying everywhere, and you kind of have no control over it, especially if you're over water. That's the worst part. In a video that I'm either have posted or gonna post very soon, I actually flew it. I flew it at a cool spot, and some of my friends, they're cliff jumping, and I sent the drone out, and I didn't have GPS, so it went crazy, and it hit a tree, and I almost lost it because it fell. It hit the tree, and then it fell a good 20 feet. Thank God it picked back up, so I saved it. But yeah, that is tip number 1. Make sure when you take off, you have GPS signal. That is very important. Tip number 2, I'm gonna be talking about the controller. Make sure when you take off, your antennas are pointed, they're flat, and then they're pointed straight out. Not up, they're straight out. I'll show a little clip of it while I'm talking, but this is pretty much so you get the best connection possible. If you do it any other way, you might have some errors with it, but this is what I've found the best way to have the best connection. Because I've actually flown with them vertical and I'll lose signal sometimes, but if they're straight, you have a pretty much perfect connection. That pretty much wraps up tip number 2. Tip number 3, I'm gonna be talking about your white balance and make sure you set it accordingly to where you are. Now, actually, I didn't even know this was a thing until, I wanna say, a few days ago. I was flying and I found it in the settings. You can adjust pretty much the color temperature, the white balance, to whatever you need it to be at. Say it's cloudy, they have a setting for that. If it's sunny, they have settings for that. And then it really goes on and on. You can set it to whatever you find to be optimal and whatever works for you, really. But I didn't even know this was a thing, so make sure you take use of that, because it honestly makes your footage look a whole lot better for being, you know, realistic about that. I guess that's tip number 3. Tip number 4, we're going to be talking about the gimbal settings and how you can adjust that to get better footage that works for you. So for me, I like to keep it around 4, no higher than 10. 10 is my maximum, like I will not go above that. And here's the mistake I've been making for a few months actually. I did not know it was a thing, and the little gimbal control, I have to barely move it to get the camera to smooth down very slow, and that was my mistake. Turns out you can set it to a super low value, so even if you turn the gimbal wheel all the way, the camera, it'll pan down super slow, so you get real nice crisp shots, and this is really what you want to have. So make sure when you're flying you have that chance to whatever works for you. It's all a preference thing, like I've said. Tip number 5 is the function button that you have on your on the remote. Now you can set this to a bunch of things, and I like to keep it set where you can make the camera pitch up and down. That's what I like to have it at, honestly. It really does come in handy, because if you're just, you know, flying and you want to say your gimbal speed super low and you want to look down real quick, all you have to do is you hit that button and it'll point straight down, and that's really nice. It's a nice function to have, honestly. Like as you see, I'm at a local dam, and I'm really considering flying my drone here. I haven't done it yet, but it would make for some really cool footage. So I think I'm gonna do that coming up here very shortly. But anyways, those are the 5 tips. So now I'm probably gonna fly at the dam. So I hope you enjoy.